Welcome back. We'll continue the theories applied in community health nursing. Next theory is Betty Newman's system model. So, what is the major concept here? It is given by Newman in 2002. Okay. Here the content is the variable of the person in interaction with the internal and external environment comprise the whole client system. So, whole client system is a person or a patient who is living in a particular area. And his internal environment as well as external environment affect his body and health. So, what is central core in this? What is the basic structure? The common client survival factors in unique individual characteristics representing basic system energy resources. The basic structure or central core is made up of the basic survival factor, which include normal temperature, range, genetic structure, response pattern, organ strength or weakness, ego structure. So what is the basic? There are around three, four structures, I guess. In that, first middle one is central core. Central core means it contains the basic structure, okay, basic structure of a human. He need the normal temperature range, his genetic structure, the genetic structure and response pattern, organ strength or weakness, ego structure. This everything comprises in this central core. So the stability occurs when the amount of energy that is available exceeds the being used by the system. So when stability occurs is he should have the energy to do all his activity and still there should be little more energy remaining in the body. Okay, that is what stability means here. A homeostatic body system is constantly in a dynamic process of input, output, feedback and compensation, which leads to a state of balance. So what is balance? There should be a negative effect as well as a positive effect. Both should comprise into a one factor, that is the homeostasis. Okay, homeostasis should have input as well as output. With that, there should be a feedback and compensation, and that will lead to a balanced state of a person. Next, degree to reaction, that is the amount of system instability resulting from stressor invasion of the normal LOD, that is line of defense. So how much stressor or stress, whatever the thing causing the stress is called stressor. So how much stressor is invaded a person body, that is called, and due to that, how much line of defense is faced by a person, that is the degree of reaction. Okay, your body reaction to the stressors is called degree of reaction. And the entropy, a process of energy depletion and disorganization moving the system toward illness or possible death. Entropy means you are losing yourself, losing your energy, losing your balance, and that may lead to your illness and sometime there will be death. So that is what entropy means. So there is a circle that has three system or three lines. Okay, the basic was central core, what we have seen, and three more layers are LOR, FLD and NLD. Okay, the Newman model is illustrated by multiple circles which demonstrate the patient line of defense. So these are the three main defenses: lines of resistance, flexible lines of defense and normal line of defense. This structure of Newman system model will be referred to throughout the case study, which will be presented later. Okay. So this is what it looks like, Newman system model. The basic is, or center is, a central core, and the first layer is lines of resistance, second is normal line of defense, and third one is flexible line of defense. Okay. So what is flexible line of defense? It is a protective accordion like mechanism that surrounds and protects the normal LOD from invasion by stressors. Okay, this flexible LOD is a outermost, see, you have seen here, outermost, okay, that will protect the second layer, that is NLD, okay, normal line of defense, from the stressors. Next, normal LOD, it represents what the client has become over time or the usual state of wellness. It is considered dynamic because it can expand or contract over time. So it is a usual state of wellness. It is considered dynamic because it can expand as well as contract over time. When you need the difference, that may expand, or when you no need, it can contract. So that is called normal LOD. This is protected by flexible LOD. Next is line of resistance, that is the innermost layer which is covering the core. The series of concentric circles that surrounds the basic structure. Okay, this is a series of circle or a layer of circle which surrounds the core. Protection factors activated when stressors have penetrated the normal LOD, causing a reaction symptomatology. Okay, when the stressor is cross the flexible and normal LOD, then LOR get activated for the stressors. Okay. The example is mobilization of WBC and activation of immune system mechanism. So here immune system will be activated when the stressors crosses the normal line of defense. Then what is the input and output? Here the matter, energy and information exchanged between client and environment that is entering or leaving the system at any point in time. So input means the system or any energy or information entering to the body, and when it leaves it is called output. And open system, a system in which there is continuous flow of input and process, output and feedback. It's a system of organized complexity where all elements are in interaction. So this is a kind of balanced state. Here everything is there, like input, output, process and feedback, everything is there. It's like a balanced state. There is an interaction between these elements. Next is prevention as intervention. Here, interventions modes for nursing action and determinants for entry of both client and nurse into a healthcare system. So this means here client and nurse will both enter to the healthcare system for a continuous treatment and nursing action. Reconstitution means the return and maintenance of system stability following treatment for stresses reaction, which may result in a higher or lower level of illness. So reconstitution means it is a change in the system stability, okay, return and maintenance of system stability after a treatment for a stressors reaction. So it may result in the high level of wellness or low level of wellness. That is called reconstitution, the health what you are getting after the treatment. Next is a stability, a state of balance of harmony requiring energy exchanges as the client adequately copes with the stresses to retain, attain or maintain an optimal level of health, thus preserving system integrity. So it is a kind of balance to maintain his optimal health, okay, optimal level of health, and he is preserving his own health. That's what stability means. And the stressors, environmental factors, that may be intra means emotion and feeling, that is inside our body. Inter, that is role expectation, that may be between the person and environment. And extra personal, that is job or finance pressure and other natural event that have potential for disrupting system stability. So these are the stressors or stress acting or stress making factors which will result in the changes in the health and the system. A stressor is any phenomenon that might penetrate both the F and N LOD, resulting either a positive or negative outcome. So stressor means any phenomenon that may be positive or negative that will invade both F and N line of defense, and which will result in the certain outcome that may be positive or negative. So Newman, she categorizes stressors as like intrapersonal, interpersonal and extrapersonal. Okay, these are capable of producing either a positive or negative effect, what we have seen already, and is any environmental force which can potentially affect the stability of the system. Okay, already we have seen intrapersonal means it's occurring within the person, example is an infection, and interpersonal it occurs between individual and environment, example role expectations. Extrapersonal, it occurs outside the individual, that is a job or finance concerns. Okay, it's already we have seen. So as a part of the reaction, a person system can adapt to a stressor and effect known as reconstitution. So this also we have seen. Reconstitution means his body is adapting to the new situation, okay, based on the stressor activity, that is called reconstitution. And wellness and illness. Wellness is the condition in which all system parts and subparts are in harmony with the whole system of the client. So entire body in the stage of balance, and that is called wellness. And illness is a changes in the balance, that's what. It's a state of insufficiency with disrupting needs unsatisfied. That is also given by Newman in 2002. Okay, it's insufficiency caused due to stressors in the body. That is what illness. She gives three levels of prevention, that is primary, secondary and tertiary. So the primary nursing intervention that will focus on keeping stressors and the stress response from having a detrimental effect on the body. So primary prevention, that means the person should not get the should not come in contact with the stressor. That's what primary prevention. It occurs before the system react to a stressor. Okay, so he is yet to meet the stressor. Okay, that is a reaction causing. It strengthens the person to enable him to better deal with stressor. So primary, in the primary prevention, you can give a health education regarding the any stressor, so that he will be prepared for that. It includes health promotion and maintenance of wellness. So here you can give a, you can take a nutritional rich foods and exercise and coping with the situation, and you can go for a counseling like that. Okay, that's what primary prevention means. And the secondary prevention, it occurs after the system reacts to a stressor and is provided in terms of existing system. It focuses on preventing damage to the central core by strengthening the internal lines of resistance and are removing the stressor. So in the secondary prevention, it is about the treatment, okay, detection and treatment. Here you will detect it and you will give a treatment to remove the stressors. Okay, it's a prevention of damage to the central core. Okay, if the central core is damaged, then your whole system will go off. It's like a CPU. Okay, when something happened to the CPU, entire system will shut down. Okay, like that, your body also will be shut down if the stressors will act on the central core of your body. Next is tertiary prevention. It occurs after the system has been treated through secondary prevention strategies, offers support to the client and attempts to add energy to the system or reduce energy needed in order to facilitate reconstitution. So tertiary prevention is about the rehabilitation. Okay, here rehabilitation means reconstitution, how you will cope up with the situation or the after the treatment of stressors. So that's what mean in the tertiary prevention. Next, moving to the Salmon White's concept for public health nursing. It's another theory, but not much important. You may need this for 2 marks or question. It's given by Mark Salmon White. He describes a public health as an organized social effort to protect, promote, and restore the health of people, and public health nursing as focused on achieving the maintaining public health. So what is public health means? Here, or societal effort and organizational effort to protect, promote and restore the health of people. That is what the aim should be in the organization, and it is focusing on the achieving and maintaining the public health. Okay, and he gave 3 practice priorities, that is prevention of disease and poor health, protection against the disease and external agents, and promotion of health. So this is what 3 main priorities he is given, that is prevention of disease, protection against disease and promotion of health. So that's what about the theories which are present in the community health nursing. We'll see in the next chapter. Thank you.